Hello students, welcome back to this YouTube channel. Today in the series of CCSP we will be continuing with chapter number 2 of SP portion, that is company secretary. In the further parts of this video we have already seen that we have studied about introduction, about KMP, the five most important personals or personals for a company or organizations. Then qualities of a company secretary, qualification of a company secretary. Then we have learned about the appointment of company secretary, and then we have talked about responsibilities, functions and duties of a company secretary. Today we will be learning about authority and limitations of a company secretary. Authority means we can say power. What are the powers? What powers are there with the company secretary? And on the other hand, limitations and liabilities means what are the responsibilities of a company secretary, or for what matters a company secretary is answerable to the company. Okay, talking with authority of a secretary. Company Act doesn't provide specifically for the authority of secretary. There is no term as authority, or there is no clause of authority in the company secretary. Company secretary ke act mein, companies act mein, company secretary ke liye koi authority is defined nahi hai. There is no authority is defined for a company secretary. There is a provision for authority in the articles of association, but in the articles of association of a company there is a provision for authority of company secretary. Means authority of company secretary is not defined by Companies Act. Rather, it is defined by articles of association. Okay, and if by any case it is not defined in article of association, then board of directors can pass a resolution and the authority of the secretary can be given or can be described. Okay, now what kind of authorities can be described? First one, to register the necessary document with the registrar of companies to obtain certificate of incorporation. To maintain the documentation of process of the organization, plus to obtain a certificate of incorporation. Certificate of incorporation means a certificate which is needed for every joint stock company, for every company to start the business. So it is the authority of company secretary to follow the process and complete the process. Next, the secretary is the head of office administration. He has the authority to look after and control the various departments of the company. We already studied read this. Secretary is the head of office administration. So as being the head, he has the authority to look and control the departments of the company. Third, company secretary is authorized to sign the letters related to allotment of share, calls on shares, forfeiture of shares, share transfer, etc. Means all the documentation process, or we can say all the communication process or letters related to share, is signed by a company secretary. Whether it is issue of share, allotment, to give share, to cancel share, to call share, to transfer share. Okay, so company secretary is authorized for the same. Okay, so next authority is the secretary undertakes correspondence with different parties on behalf of the company. Correspondence here means communication. So secretary does the communication on behalf of company with the different parties. Secretary is authorized to work as agent of the company. Work as a agent of a company means secretary can, wherever secretary goes, secretary represent the company. Secretary represents the company, and the secretary, the company is responsible for the act done by secretary as per power assigned by the board of directors. Whatever the powers are assigned by board of directors, secretary is responsible, or company is responsible for the act done under that power. For example, secretary, company has assigned secretary a power to communicate. So if something is communicated by secretary, and is if it is got it is and if it goes wrong, then कंपनी इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दैट एक्ट ऑफ सेक्रेटरी. कंपनी कैन नॉट से दैट ओनली सेक्रेटरी इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल. एंड द लास्ट अथॉरिटी इज गिवन इज सेक्रेटरी इज ऑथराइज टू एग्जीक्यूट द वर्क एज पर डायरेक्शन ऑफ बोर्ड. वॉट एवर डायरेक्शन ऑफ बोर्ड इज गिवन दैट एज पर दैट बोर्ड लिमिट द कंपनी सेक्रेटरी कैन एग्जीक्यूट एनी वर्क एज पर हिज ऑथराइजेशन. क्लियर. सो दिस वर द सेवन अथॉरिटीज. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट लिमिटेशंस. फर्स्ट लिमिटेशन इज इफ द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स हैड नॉट इंस्ट्रक्टेड द सेक्रेटरी कैन नॉट कन्वीन एनी मीटिंग एज पर हिज विश. कॉन्ट्रडिक्टरी टू सेवन. इन द सेवेंथ विश अथॉरिटी सेक्रेटरी इज ऑथराइज टू एग्जीक्यूट द वर्क. मीन्स वॉट एवर वर्क इज गिवन टू सेक्रेटरी, सेक्रेटरी कैन एग्जीक्यूट इट इन एनी वे ही वॉन्ट्स. बट limitation, if we talk about limitation, the company has to organize a meeting, but till the board of directors had not given permission to organizing a meeting to company secretary, he cannot convene, he cannot call a meeting. Second, the company secretary cannot borrow finance on behalf of the company for company affairs. On behalf of the company, if company wants money, company secretary cannot borrow it. Company secretary cannot borrow it. Now, secretary can help to prepare agreements, but he cannot enter into agreement. Yes, company secretary can prepare a documentation, can prepare agreements for the company, but he cannot sign it, he cannot enter into the agreements. Fourth, the secretary cannot take any decisions on policy matters. Secretary can help board of directors, top level management for policy related decisions, but he cannot take any decisions on behalf of company. Fifth, the agreement enter into are null or void. Null means zero and void means cancel. Any agreement in for which secretary has signed and entered on behalf of board or company, that agreement is cancel or zero, null or void, and company is not bound for it. And last is the secretary cannot issue shares to public without authority. Although the power for issuing share is with the company secretary, but without the authority's permission, he cannot issue share to anyone. These were the liabilities of authority. Now talking about liabilities of company secretary. Company secretary is responsible for the following circumstances. Company secretary is responsible if he violates or breaks any provision, rules or regulations of Companies Act. Company secretary is responsible if he does not submit necessary documents to the registrar of company in the given time. He is responsible if he misuse his power or take commission secretly from the business deals or anything like this, and also liable for punishment. Punishment can be financial penalty in the form of fine or penalty, or it can be imprisonment, means jail or anything else like that. Fourth, company secretary is responsible for any act beyond the powers delegated, misappropriation of fund and fraud. Anything done beyond the power given to him, he is responsible for it. Any fraud, he is responsible. Any misappropriation means misguidance or misrepresentation of funds, money, company secretary is responsible. Next is, company secretary is responsible for any loss that occurs to company due to willful negligence of duty. Means if he neglected any of his duty and due to that, any loss is there to the company, then company secretary is responsible. Company secretary is also responsible for not writing recommendation or minutes of the meeting. If minutes of meeting has not been written by the company secretary, he is responsible. Company secretary is also responsible if he fails to present annual reports in the general meetings within the time, prescribed time. And last one, company secretary is responsible for any unauthorized changes made by him in the documents. Means changes made by him without the permission, without the authority, he is responsible. So these were the authorities, liabilities against the authority and liabilities of a company secretary. For any problem or any doubt, please fill down the comment section. Till then, stay home, stay safe, happy learning.